So in that case, we all educators, even if the board, CBSE, as well as my entire principals forum is working on that, we may not, you know, we may not allow all the children together to come to school due to this distancing. You know, we need to keep distancing, social distancing, or you can say a common distancing is required when the children will come back to school. The entire process has to be revamped, and we need to plan out a strategy how children will come, and if children will come, whether we'll have the face-to-face class for all the children or not. So what we have planned, the e-learning concept will continue, and 50% children of a class will be allowed to come one day, and this other 50% children will be attending the e-learning classes at home. So a simultaneous, the face-to-face and e-learning classes will continue for another, you can say, maybe 3 to 4 months, or even if to, it can extend, it can be extended to 6 months.
So as you very rightly said, sir, that it is going to continue for 3 to 4 months. This will stay with the universities and colleges as well, and hence bringing up a very, very significant dimensional change in the way students will now pick careers, because there are a lot of careers which needs hands-on, you know, you have to be in the laboratories, you have to have hands-on practice. So do you see students opting for more and more careers which can be accessed online? Do you see a new pattern emerging?
Yes, of course. You see, it may be a job, or it may be taking an opportunity for any specific courses are concerned. When you talk about the examinations, which the child has to opt to get a seat for JEE entrance or JEE, or get a seat in engineering colleges or medical college, even if the children are now appearing the NEET examination online or JEE examination online too, similar way, there will be a lot of opportunities where children or students or candidates, they go abroad or they study in various universities of repute. So in that case, you know, National Testing Agency has taken up the responsibility to conduct all sort of examinations through online only, so that children, by sitting at, you know, in a particular center or sitting at home also, they can appear the examination, and the selection of seats can be possible in different colleges.
I would request all the, I will just type down, kindly open the microphone if you are not audible, or use headphone.
Sir,
coming back to the next very important question, which is kind of in everyone's mind, and every university or engineering or technical institution is worried about, that there will be no movement of students from, let us say, one state to another state, or there will be no movement of students from India to abroad. So therein, every year we used to see a lot of students opting for universities outside India. Now, are institutions in India equipped enough to give that sort of education that the foreign universities offer?
Yes, of course, because as of now, when schools are ready, beforehand schools were, school teachers were not equipped with techno-savvy things. Even if now also, when the requirement occurs, the school teachers have started using all these teaching and learning material through online. So I think it is what we have discussed with JNU, what we have discussed with other universities of repute, as far as Manipal University is concerned, as far as Amity University is concerned, as far as all technical universities are concerned, they all are ready with the online courses. They are all ready with, you know, these process of learning will continue from the month of August, September. And they are all absolutely ready. I was discussing with some of the university vice chancellors also. So as per the requirement, the university will prepare the module and start teaching the candidates, those who will be getting admissions in these universities in India.
As you rightly put, sir, we at MIT also were one of the first institutions to start online mode of teaching. And we have trained our teachers also to be ready for the future uncertainties. But the questions again, which I'll ask you is that what careers do you see blooming in the coming days? Which career field do you see blooming where students will take more interest in the coming days to come?
You see, very interesting, and this is a very important questions for the present, generation children, those will come out and they are now in a pandemic situation. I believe that the fastest growing jobs or new generation jobs will be first one, will be at present situation is the medical one, because the pandemic is in a situation, such a situation that everyone is now trying to develop the medical job facility all over the country. It may be the health educators, it may be the medical scientists, it may be your ultrasound diagnostic medical sonographers, or you can say the biomedical surgeons, or you can say the occupational therapy consultants. These all area, when in the aging of the population and a growing focus on health issues, will drive demand for better medical devices and equipment, as all now vaccine has also not come up. So there is an inclination all over the world that there will be an inclination of getting more number of courses or more number of jobs in these areas. This is number one in the present generation is concerned, or the present crisis, whatever it is happening. That way, the medical, areas will be taken care of as a first priority. So, but the second one, I can say very important, with the advent of technology and the world moving at a very rapid pace, there is no surprise that we will be witnessing an advancement in different careers. So there will be a variety of careers, but still, if 25 years back, or if you see 15 years back at least, there were only doctors and engineers were the only criteria for the parents to have a job or to go for a career. But now I believe number one is your data science. So data science is the most promising and in-demand career path for the skilled professionals, those who want to go in that direction. So you should have knowledge in coding and be aware of that syndrome like SAS or Python, etc. These children are very interested to go beyond, go towards that. So data science is, it is growing 6.5 times a year, I'm telling you. So as data science is the real game changer for a, particularly for a business or any business problems. So I think this will be a major factor of putting up or going toward this career. The second one I can go for artificial intelligence. All of you know, according to the world scenario or World Education Forum says that 133 million jobs are now, it is getting created by AI till 2022. So the brighter future appears to be in the grip of artificial intelligence, what I supposed to think, find it out. So beside that, lot many new generation machines are enabled with AI. All of us know that what exactly is AI, because that is my favorite subject as a CBSE trainer, and we are working on artificial intelligence long way. So we see this career is a very brighter career for the Indian generation is concerned. So now generation, you might be knowing that AI is a major factor, and AI has been used everywhere. So people can go for, you might have gone through the Alexa. The Alexa is the machine which drives the voice, voice recognition. He can find out the voice recognition. So robot is also there. Robotics are there who can answer your question. You might have seen the voice of Tesla's, voice of Sophia, a new robot has come. So these all very interesting things are there.
Sir, also I wanted to ask one more question. When we are on artificial intelligence and data sciences and all, do you see in the other core branches, let us say like mechanical engineering or electrical engineering, electronics and communication engineering, they also kind of now being in demand for supplying the backup equipment and coming up with, you know, equipments which can help the healthcare sector?
Yes, of course. You know, see, when you talk about the other mechanical part of the area, the connectivity area of maybe your technology, maybe your medical sciences, everywhere these other areas are very much connected. So unless and until they get equipped, those people, they get equipped, or you can say the masons, the engineering aspects of people, if they do not get up with, we do not bring them up, so automatically the usage of these products will not be fruitful. So simultaneously, as I believe that simultaneously these people also need to be, you know, they have to take up these careers, maybe engineering factors or whatever you say. So that also need to be worked out simultaneously.
One more thing, you know, being a CBSE resource person, it was a blessing in disguise that few years back, CBSE introduced entrepreneurship as one of their subjects. Do you think that now it was like kind of a blessing in disguise that today, when all these students who will pass out class 12, will use that entrepreneurship training and we'll see a lot of entrepreneurs coming up?
Absolutely. Whenever we discuss in our school also, I believe in India, in other countries you might have seen, every parent want to make his or her child an entrepreneur. So why to be a job, you know, you need to work as a job in a company as a job holder. Why not to create few, you know, job, you know, create a company like that so that you can appoint so many job people, seekers into your company. So we promote all these things in the school level too. Many a children, they want to have become their own entrepreneur, to establish their own factories, industries. It happens when the child comes in class 12, they go with that fundamental. So I believe when the child move away from a class 12 examination, after passing class 12 examination, we generally as a CBSE principal, we found 50% of children, they want to stand up or bring up their own company, own factories, own innovation, own creativity within them. So it is always welcome that, you know, in India, children should have an inclination towards becoming an entrepreneur.
What advice will you give institutions like ours, MIT, in the post-COVID-19 situation, that, you know, in terms of our academic practices, in terms of academic courses, what advice as a CBSE resource person you will give us?
You see, I know that your institution, colleges, you are going very well and at par the standard of the all other universities around. So what exactly I want that as a CBSE resource person or as a school principal or a school teacher, if at all a child moves away from my school to your university, it is something we believe that they have taken up a broader challenge to go to your institute. And when they have gone to your institute, they expect maximum. The expectation of parents becomes double. So, in the same case, when the expectation of parents become double, so children, they want to perform better. So I want that the platform which you are all giving, the platform should be so handy, so comfortable that whenever after passing your courses from your college, when they get any, you know, when they go through any campus selection, those children should come out with some very, very flying colors, that whenever and wherever they go, that they will keep their name of MIT institution. Yes, these are the children of these institutions and they have been trained, they have been groomed in such a way. It's not only getting a certificate, it's only, they have done such courses that they will be a life examples for wherever they go to work in any other company. So I want the platform to be made very practical, very experiential learning. When this experiential learning or practical based learning happens in your institute, I think children will be, in a broader sense, they will be very brighter, you know, aspects of job, your curators, and they can be a good entrepreneur in the days to come. They can give a good product wherever they go to work anywhere. So I believe a good platform you need to give them, and the exposure which they will get, it should match with any other university of the world. That I expect.
I see a lot of my senior colleagues here. If there is any question from any of our senior colleagues, he can unmute or she can unmute herself and ask the question.
It will be a pleasure for me to talk to or give the answer.
Mr. Arora, Mr. Devendra Arora, sir?
Yeah, I am here. I am waiting. Then someone asks for me.
So please, you go ahead. You go ahead.
Amit ji, please do come.
Okay.
Vijay Negi, welcome. Yes. Ask whatever you ask from Dr. Priyadarshi Nayak. He is an international figure with us.
Good afternoon, sir. This is Dr. A.K. Ahuja. And,
good afternoon.
Yeah, thank you very much for coming this at this platform and guiding us toward what is happening at the school level. And
it's my pleasure.
Yeah, thank you, sir. And my question is that nowadays, as you mentioned, that medical electronics is going to get some potential boom in times to come because of these situations. So in what way CBSE is modulating their curriculum in terms of hands-on in electronics or robotics or likewise courses, likewise basic skills? I have seen HTML, Java at the school level 7th and 8th. My children are also in 7th class, 7th standard now. He has HTML in his curriculum. But how robotics, electronic basic skill, hands-on are being introduced, or what is the perspective plan in CBSE? Can you please guide us?
Yes, absolutely. CBSE has this year, you know, as far as robotics are concerned, even if it was not introduced by CBSE as a course or a curriculum earlier days or in the earlier years, but now artificial intelligence is a subject which has been included by the board as a sixth subject. The children can opt as a subject and they can have a career in this. So AI, what exactly artificial intelligence is enhancing our lives. CBSE has thought of that artificial intelligence can be integrated in all the subjects in the days to come. It helps us, you know, to know or connect in various ways. So I believe the intake or the decision which was taken by board to include as a particular subject in class 8, 9, 10. Now children will be opting in class 11th also the artificial intelligence as their subject. So once this is introduced, I think there is a lot of scope as far as IoT is concerned or machine learning is concerned. So these all computer-based, thinking will develop, and children after passing class 12, they can go for a BTech in computer science, for going for a cloud computing expert. They can go for a machine learning expert. They can go for artificial intelligence. There are a lot of areas where job is created. I believe you all might be knowing. Netflix used cloud computing services. So Netflix started working towards becoming a software technology for cloud computing. Most of their things ran through Amazon or web services. So for that, children, they need to be BTech in computer science. So CBSE, by thinking that, yes, in the future, they have to go for this BTech. So they should have a common knowledge as far as artificial intelligence is concerned or machine learning is concerned. You all might be knowing the latest example of digital info transformation, making the digital world even more convenient and reliable. You all might be knowing Siri. Siri, or in the mobile phone, we have a Siri. They respond to human interaction. So for this also, everyone has a curiosity to learn on this. So the qualification is a must when you go for a higher degree as a BTech degree in computer science, followed by master degrees or PhD. But a normal fundamental things is required for school children to know and understand so that they will go for BTech. So board has adopted this artificial intelligence as a subject from class 8 onwards. Even if in the days to come, we can have this artificial intelligence subject from class 1 onwards. But now basically from class 8, 9, 10th, 11th, CBSE has opted this particular subject. So I think this will have a longer option, you know, growth and of putting up all these things in a career in the days to come. It will help us.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Because digital marketing is as a career now for all the children.
Yeah, yeah.
So artificial intelligence is adopted as a subject in CBSE.
Okay, I have.
Dr. Nayak, sorry, sir. Please continue, sir. Please
I have one more question which is linked to my first question. That nowadays, do you not think that we need to have career counseling at the school level, depending upon their potential? What potential children have, we must suggest a career from the sixth or seventh level, so that they do not find geo parity once they reaches in 12th as to which path to choose. So, do you not think? And if yes, then in what way CBSE is handling this issue in the school level?
You see, career counselor as a career, you know, in school also we are having counselors, we are having career counselors. So it's not only in schools, but I believe this career is at its peak. India, as far as I know and as an analysis is concerned, India in need of 1.4 million career counselors required now for 350 plus million students. We are having 350 plus million students for which we may require around more than 1.4 million career counselors. So believe me, from the school level onwards, the career counseling processes we have also started, and children should know there are lots of career. It's not only doctor, engineer, or they will go for a lawyer. It's not like that. So there are lots of career, and we are in the CBSE from class 11, 12 onwards. We are conducting a regular counseling, career counseling sessions for children specifically, and so that they can opt different careers. And as far as taking up a career counselor as a career also, even if we train children to take up this career counselor as a career also. So this we are doing it. I hope career counselor is, as I already told you, it is at a high peak. We all required good career counselors. We can produce this as a subject too in different courses.
Right. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for your
input. Yeah. Thank you, Dr. Priyadarshi. I wish to introduce more about Dr. Priyadarshi. Dr. Priyadarshi is a international speaker, and along with us from 2015, together we organized more than 50 seminars. More than, not yes, only yes. In India, but Singapore, Sri Lanka, and rest of the other countries also. And out of those seminars, I learn also artificial, being a management learner, I learn also the AI and that machine learning from very eminent professor, Dr. M.M. Pant, and so many other national and international professors. So Dr. Priyadarshi Nayak have a passion to create a awareness of advanced technology towards his 6th, 7th class student and 11th, 12th also. He believes when students has ready to open his or her eyes, immediately you give them or throw them a new information, like we throw our mobile phone to them. Even then our kid is just age of 2 years, 3 years, and that kid ready to learn. So he believes in that philosophy. And you all are welcome to in his further seminar and his CED, that Center for Education Development and School Initiate. He is a passionate and MIT mad man for the making a career of not only an Indian student, but also the worldwide. So we are very proud to, I am very proud to introduce Dr. Priyadarshi with our MIET group, with this intelligent professor are with us. Professor Vijay Negi, I request you, please, just you throw light on this. Professor Vijay Negi, welcome. Yeah. I can see you now, huh? Your new style.
Can you hear me, sir?
Yeah.
Your voice a little, yes. You're not out audible. Okay, before Mr. Negi is audible to us, Dr. Nayak, I wanted to ask you one very important question. As a student, there is a tendency that students ask their teachers or principal before opting for an institution or before opting for a career, they do come to their principal and teachers to take guidance. So what is the checklist that you give to the students to before choosing an institution?
You see, as far as class 12 children are concerned, when you talk about when my children will pass out from class 12, they will go for some universities or colleges. So there is first option is what are the careers they are going to choose up, we will take up that. And you know, when we talk about going for a career as taking up an engineering courses or medical courses, they go for this entrance examinations. We take up all area this, and beside that, there are a lot of other careers, and I believe that the options are with us with a lot of, because we used to have a lot of companies to come to us, and because when these discussion happens, campus selection happens, so we invite colleges, we invite you know, other universities or other people where we see that our children should go, because we produce, we have almost 24 schools in India, and Dune Public School is one of the recognized one, and we produce almost every year thousands of children, they pass out class 12, and when they pass out, we plan out their structure and we select the best colleges of India, even if they abroad also, we take up all those things. But now, as due to this COVID-19, we had also conducted one seminar at Delhi for all our children, even if we have invited children from other schools, universities also, and we have given a whole soul, these are all best colleges, universities altogether, and we empower the parents that these are the things, these are the fee structure, these are the you know, after the learning outcome, means after passing out, they are the placements, how many children they have got placements. So the statistical structure, we place it in front of the parents so that we give an open hand to the parents to choose the best colleges and universities to study abroad.
So you have mentioned about data sciences, you have mentioned about artificial intelligence, you have mentioned about robotics. What career options do you see in the fields like pharmacy, in biotechnology, and in management?
I told you, ki, because in this particular junction, I believe medical sciences already I have spoken to you, and it may be your Ayurvedic, it may be your pharmacy. This career options are all also there. Children are very much inclined to this. I believe this, as health can cost continue to rise, and health education provides cost effective ways to teach people how to live healthy lives. So there are people, there are children, those who want to do these courses. So we have planned out a structured, when we go for medical, though, then we talk about the biomedical surgeons, those who want to have occupational therapy assistant area, that we find out. Those who want to go for the diagnostic medical sonographers, we divide that one. Those who want to go for pharmacy area, we divided that one. So when we talk to our kids also, we bifurcated all the fastest growing jobs as far as medical line is concerned, that we do it. And pharmaceutical is almost a part of it. We explain the children to the pros and cons of putting up, taking up this career as option.
Do you think healthcare management and disaster management coming up as the most wanted courses in coming days to come?
Yes.
Do you see healthcare management and disaster management being the most prominent courses when it comes to management?
I told you in the very beginning, when somebody asked me what all the career options or career jobs now for the new age, I told you the fastest requirement at the present junction is the medical area. Because in the pandemic situation has become like that everyone is concerned now. Because in India, you might have seen, in other countries you have seen, even if Italy is such a developed country with, as far as medical occupation, medical facilities are concerned, they are striving hard to save people. So I think the whole nation, the entire nation, as well as the whole world is worried, and they need to develop the medical sciences at par with any other things which we are doing it. So in the present junction, the health educators, job or health educators courses, the medical scientist courses, the diagnostic medical courses, the biomedical surgeons, courses to be developed in a rapid way. Otherwise, you know, there is no sustainability when like US like country is unable to tackle this present pandemic situation. So we are very much concerned. Indian government is also concerned about it.
Mr. Negi has typed a question. I'll read it out to you, sir. He asked, nowadays IT industry has a lot of opportunity like a video entrepreneur, finding any social problem and providing solutions via app or social networking tool. So do you see that app creating or video entrepreneurs also emerging as a prominent career?
Yes, you all of you know IoT, Internet of Things, as a career. And you know, examples are many. You know, sound watches, you know, they track the daily activities, you know, GPS is to navigate all those things. So you know, even if you want to turn off an AC sitting at your office, it is possible nowadays. So by 2025 there will be you know, this IoT devices, lot of other devices are coming up, and there will be around 40 billion you know, connection of IoT devices will come up, which will help us to diagnose thing from sitting from home and doing all sort of industrial and everyday use. That can happen.
HOD of Biotech's Dr. Nitin Sharma is asking you, sir.
Yes.
Will you recommend any syllabus revision of pharmaceutical sciences and biotechnology? Do you see any syllabus revision in upcoming days?
Yes, because you know, the entire whichever is connected with medical sciences, that already I was you know, I had attended one seminar or webinar of Harshvardhan ji. He has categorically mentioned that he is working on the areas as far as medical areas is concerned. The entire curriculum is going to be changed and new things will be added to this, so that the medical inputs and medical outputs will be developed.
Mr. Kamesh, you can unmute yourself and ask your question. Mr. Kamesh, if you want to, you can unmute yourself. Okay, he is asking, sir, how can you, his question is,
yes,
how do you see mathematics stream, you know, in the coming days to, in coming days, how do you see mathematics as a stream changing as a career option?
Yes, you see, in CBSE, when we talk about mathematics, always children take it a very little difficult way. And for that, we have come up with few things. One is mathematics has been to make mathematics more interesting. There are two mathematics. One is basic mathematics and advanced mathematics has come up in the school levels. So basic mathematics and advanced mathematics, those who are very strong in mathematics, they will be opting advanced mathematics. Those who have, you know, they fear in taking up mathematics, they will be taking the basic mathematics. But another one, the mathematics has a large scope in the out world, when you can say about getting it more into connection with the science and mathematics and all. So applied mathematics as a subject has been added into CBSE, which, you know, from this year onwards, class 11 children will be opting applied mathematics, as applied mathematics has a brighter future in the days to come, when you connect with engineering, when you connect with all mechanical and other parts of the things.
Very well, sir. Mr. Rahul Joshi wanted to. Mr. Rahul Joshi, can you unmute yourself?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Please do.
Very good afternoon, sir. Sir, as I'm having my specialization in nanotechnology and I'm MSc in physics, I want to ask you that what is the scope of this nanotechnology for future? Because I'm not seeing this nanotechnology subject that is the having huge impact in coming technologies. It's not in UG courses, not even in introduced in our school level. We are not even having the introduction of these. And we know that in nowadays every field of technology is merging towards the nanotechnology.
Oh, yes, there are few courses, as you told, nanotechnology and other things are not yet included. But I think the world scenario says that these nanotechnology also will come into existence, because nowadays everyone is confined to a specific, that is artificial intelligence. era has come up now. So everyone is going on into IoT, the machine learning, the computational thinking, everything has come. But the nanotechnology, there are children, there are universities who are working on this. I think in the days to come, this will also have an importance. So nothing to be worried about it.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Dr. Nayak, at the peril of sounding a little cynical, I wanted to ask you one question. What is your take on the trainings of the teachers when it comes to 10 plus 2 level?
Training and development is my own area. So right, as a principal, I'm there. I have worked in CBSE for 26 years. But as a trainer, I am the CBSE trainer. I am a resource person of CBSE on 11 modules. And beside that, I am training, I am taking up career counseling sessions. So I believe in present situation, training of teacher is the only most requirement to groom up a teacher to the expectation of a children. Because children know everything now, everything is available in the Googles and they can frame out and they can work it out. Unless and until children, the teachers meet the expectations of the children, so children will not listen to the teachers. So teachers need to be updated with the present generation things. Teachers need to be updated with all the other training modules, effective way of teaching methods. So it may be class 10th or 12th, it may be higher, those lecturers, professors are taking their teaching methods or techniques to be very, very empowered, and it should be developed in such a way that there will be a difference. Otherwise, university will have no meaning if at all you do not have a good faculty in them. So good faculties are important, and good faculties can be called when they are very well trained and they are equipped with all other teaching methods and techniques.
If anyone has any question, or there are last Mr. Dave to take over, Dr. Dave to take over.
Yeah.
Any question?
Yes, any other question from any side? Anurag Chaudhary, want to say something? Yeah. I wish to convey my sincere thanks to Dr. Priyadarshi Nayak. And one more thing which I love to add it. The training of teacher is the core passion of, I'm not talking about the training of teacher is a core work of Dr. Priyadarshi. It's a core passion of Dr. Priyadarshi. As I see as a witness from last 5 years, almost 10 seminar organized in different part of the corner of India, either Bangalore, either Chennai, either Chandigarh or Delhi, Gurgaon, everywhere. So in every seminar, more than 200 principal and top shot academician participated to learn various upcoming sector. So on an average, from 2015 to 2020, he or me organized 50 seminars on the training of the teachers, and speaker and expert come from India and abroad, and vice chancellor and chancellor of the universities. Then total, if you see the ratio is 50 seminar, 200 principals were available there, then 10,000 teacher already trained by the Dr. Priyadarshi Nayak. So which is the big attraction, my personal attraction toward Dr. Priyadarshi Nayak? He justified his surname called Nayak. Thank you so much, Dr. Priyadarshi Nayak. Over to Vishwas.
Thank you, Dr. Dev. And Dr. Nayak, before leaving, the last question I want to ask you. In our country, there is a huge gap when it comes to the city and the countryside, the villages and the pockets where there is no reach of internet, there is no reach of technology. So how does CBSE as a leader take this challenge up and get the technology reach to those where it is not possible?
You see, it is very true that when you compare with urban area and rural area, so in the urban areas, you have only 3 lakh schools. And in the rural area, you have almost 9 lakh schools. So what I prefer, wherever there is internet facility and proper networking facilities available, so their teachers are taking up this online classes, everything is happening. But as you know, when you go to the rural areas, I think parents, they might be having at least the Android phone or the phones may be available. So in that case, I will suggest the teachers to go with the recording of their own session in a Google Drive and then transfer whenever the, you know, whichever way that is in offline mode or whichever mode it can be transferred to children that can pass on to those children where internet facility is not available always or the speed of internet is not that much good. So I think this is the only way by which we can do it. When you talk about area where the internet or the facility is not available as far as the rural area is concerned.
Dr. Nayak, it was an absolute honor and pleasure to speak to you. We'll be highly obliged if you have anything to add to what already, which has been a very enlightening session, sir.
That's lovely. It's pleasure for me that you are I'm connected today with the such a outstanding group, and you are doing all beautiful things in the university in your group, and I believe as I am a part of it. So I thank once again from my core of heart that you have called me to discuss all these scenarios, all the jobs requirement, or you can say the present generation children, they require what sort of what different jobs. I have just shared, I have connected with my views, what I used to do it in my schools when I interact with my children when they pass out class 12. That was wonderful talking to all of you, even if Dave is a very good friend of mine. We together were working since long, and I believe that your institution a brighter side and will go ahead and become prosper in the days to come. Thank you very much for inviting me to this forum.
We are honored, sir. We are honored. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
We are honored.
Lovely.
Thank you so much.
Lovely.
Thank you, Dev sir, for allowing us.
Thank you, Vijay. Thank you. Good to see you. I love to invite you in college.